Okay student, today we will discuss concept of set operation in SQL. We are having the four different types of the set operations. One is union, second one is a union all, third one is a intersect, and fourth one is a minus. So when we see that we have a four different types, how we can use it? First is a union. So for the union, it returns the row from the both the queries after eliminating the duplicated records. Mean if we are having the two different tables, from both of these tables it will take the data and eliminate all the duplicating records and then display the record. So duplicated record will not be displayed over here. So whenever we have to apply the union among two different tables, then it will eliminate the duplicated record and all the other record will be displayed. Second one is a union all. Union all operator returns the row from the both the queries including all the duplicated records. Mean union display eliminates the duplicated record while union all doesn't remove the duplicated record. Union all display the duplicated records that are available in both the tables. That same record is available in table A as well as in table B. So union all will display same record two times. Next one is the intersect operator. Intersect operators display only all of those records that are common in two different tables. That record that is available in table A as well as in table B. So intersect operator will display the record that are common in both the table. And last one we are having the minus. Minus record, minus operator will return the distinct row that are available in table A but that doesn't present in the table B. So all of those record that are that available in the table A but not available in the table B, the minus operator will display all of those records. Now how we can implement it? We see that we are having the different type of the set operator: union, union all, intersect and minus. We can implement all of these by using an Oracle or any other DBMS. Let I have to create the two different tables, and first one table is emp1 having the column id, name and date of birth. So we see that we have to create it table 1 emp1, create it. Now when we have to create the table 2 emp2, so for that one number of the column must be the same in both of these tables, right? And whenever we have to apply the different set operators, columns number of the column must be the same. We have the few different guidelines. One is the number of the column must be the same. To perform set operations, number of columns must same. It is not necessary that column names are same, but number of the column must be the same in two different tables. Where we have to apply the union or union all or intersect. Second one, the data type of the correspondence columns. Let in one column we are having data type number, in second one correspondence column we must have the data type number. If data type are not same, data type must be same in correspondence column. In the query that what we are using the query, in that one queries the columns data type must be the same. If column data types are not same, it will not perform the union or union all or intersect operations. So these are the two main guidelines. We have to take care of both of these guidelines. So first one, we see that we create one table M1. Now we have to create another table M2. We have to create the table M2. So here we create the table M2. Both the columns are here: ID, name, date of birth. Data type is number, voucher 2 and date. Here number, voucher 2 and date. Column names are the same, data types are the same. We create two different tables. Now let me insert the few records in table 1, M1, and then few records in the table 2. I already have the code to save the time for the insertion of the records. Copy it. then we have to paste it. So we insert the record in the M1. M1 we see that ID 1 name is Smith and date 12 September 01. 2 James and then this one 3 and 4. We record the we insert the 4 different record over here. Let me check select direct from M1. We have 4 different records are available. Now same we have to apply for the M2. So for M2 we have the different records are available. So we have now we have to insert the record in the table imply 2. So when we have to insert the record in table imply 2, it said a table or view does not it insert the record 1, 2, 3. Now here it said it's a table names just table name is incorrect, so let me rewrite it. M2 values, then we have to again this one records record is inserted. Now table name is here insert into M2 values 7 Albrecht and this one semicolon. Okay, now let me display the record select direct from M1. So we have 1, 2, 3 and 4 records, and then select direct from M2. So we have the two different tables are there. Here record 3, 4, 5, 6 and 7. So we have 5 different records are available over here, while in M1 we have 4 different records. If we checked over here the record in M1 table, imply 1 table, we have the record 3 and 4 that are also duplicated in the table M2. Whenever we have to take the union when we are applying the set operator in SQL, so what it will happen, it will eliminate the duplicated record, mean record 3 Smith and 10 September 02 that is available in imply table 2 as imply 1 as well as imply 2. Similarly, 4 King 3rd January 01 that is available in imply 1 as well as imply 2. So same record is repeated, so it will display when we have to apply the union. What we say, the union will remove the duplicated record, so it will just display these two records only once. So we have the 4 these records, so these two will not be displayed. Why? Because already displayed from the M1 and then these 3 records. So total it will display the 7 different record over here whenever we have to apply the union operators. So how we can create the union? So for the unions we have to write the query select steric from M1 union, then select steric from table is here M2. So we are creating the data from the two different table M1 and M2, and we are creating the union. So union will remove the duplicated record, display the all the record from both the table and remove the duplicated records. So it will display it over here only 7 record 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 and 7. While here we are having the, if we checked and imply 1 we are having 4 records, imply 2 we have the 5 records. So total are here 9 records, while 2 records are duplicated. Whenever we have a duplicated record, so union operator remove both the duplicated record. So remember that one, whenever we have to apply the union operators, union set operators, it remove the duplicated records. So the main guideline for the union operators, in the select queries we must have the data types same number of the column in both the table 1, and data type of the correspondence column must be the same. Let we are using the different queries, the data type of each column in the second query. Let we say the second query is here select steric from M2. So data type of each column in select steric from M2 must match the data type of the correspondence column in the first query that is select static from emp1. So data type of the corresponding column must be match, number of column must be match to perform the any set operation, that is either union or intersection or union all one. And second, we say that union remove the duplicated record. Similarly, we can apply the union all. When we have to apply the union all, what union all will do? Union all returns the records, rows from both the queries, including all the duplicated records. So when we have select static from emp1, so we have the four records. Select static from emp2, we have five records. So whenever we have to apply it over here, union of both these operators, so it display only seven record, remove the duplicated record. But when we have to calculate the union all, so union all will display all the records from both the table, including the duplicated record. So select static from emp1, union all. Select static from emp2. So it display it over here the 9 records. We can see it over here, record 3 and 4 from the emp1. Similarly, record 3 and 4 from the emp2. Same record are repeated. Whenever we have to use the union all will display the record from both the queries or both the table, including duplicated record, while union will display only distinct record, remove the duplicated record. That is the main difference between union and union all. Third one, we have a intersect. So intersect, when we have to calculate the intersects, intersect operator return the rows that are common in both the tables, just once. So the rows that are common in both the table M1 as well as M2. So if we check it over here in both the table, so we are having the few records are there. So in both of these tables, we are having these two records are the common, 3 Smith and 10 September 02 and 4 13 January 01. Same records are repeated over here. So when we have to display intersect operator, it will display just two records. How? Let's see. Select static from M1, intersect. Intersect, select static from emp2. So it displays just two records, the record that are common in both the table in emp1 as well as emp2. Now we have emp1 as well as emp2. We find it over here, the intersect displays only common record. Moreover, whenever we have to apply, it will check the data type of the corresponding queries that must be matched, number of column must be matched. Okay, now last one, set operator, that is a minus. What minus operator will do? Minus operator will display all of those records that are available in the table A, but those records are not available in the table B. Mean distinct records that are available in the table A, but not present in the second query or in the table B. So that is a minus. So if we again apply it over here, select static from emp1, it states we have few records. If we use it over here, select static from emp1 minus select static from M2. So it will display all of those records that are available in employ 1 but not available in the employ 2. So we know that record 3 and 4 are available in M2, but record 1 and 2, 1 Smith and 12 September 01 and 2 James 1st November 03, these two records are not available in M2. So when we have to use it over here, M1 minus M2, so it will display those records that are distinct in M1 but not present in M2. How we can use it over here? Select static from M1 minus select static from M2. It display two records that are available in the employ 1 but not available in the employ 2. Similarly, if we go in reverse, M2 minus M1, then it will display these records, like these records are there. These are not available for sorry, 5th, 6th and 7th, these are available in M2 but not available in the M1. Select steric from M2 minus select steric from M1. So it will display the three different records 5th, 6th and 7th. Those records that are available in the second table but not in the first table. So these are the four different operators. Those operators are the known as set operators, union, union all, intersection and minus. Performing these set operations, we must be very careful about these guidelines that data type and the correspondence queries must match, and second one, number of the column must match in the two different correspondence query. Thanks for watching the video.